like to request Chief Secretary, Delhi Government, Mr. Vijay Dev, to please say a few words.
Friends, good evening. Let me start with a small prayer. Teri rahmaton ka nuzul ho, mujhe mehnaton ka sila mile, mujhe maal o zar ki havas nahi, mujhe bas tu rizq e halal de. Amen. I just seek your blessings, Almighty, and I seek a honest living, nothing else. Let me at the outset convey my heartiest gratitude to EEMA family and all of you for giving me this opportunity to be present here today. And this interface, which is going to start today, I'm sure that we'll work together as a team, Government of NCT of Delhi and all of you, to ensure that Delhi goes up. It goes up as a smart city, as a happy city. Delhi, the cultural capital of India, has been stitching the fabric of India culturally, administratively, politically, socially. And administering Delhi, which is so uniquely placed in the administrative mosaic of the country, is by no means a simple task. There are problems galore. And the fact of being the capital of the nation also places on all of us, those who govern, an additional onerous responsibility of setting standards which are going to be a benchmark not only for the other states of India to follow, but also globally. And this is in the backdrop of an irony that Delhi is also a paradoxical city. The city which we take pride in, calling it as one of the greenest capital, is also simultaneously one of the most polluted cities in terms of the quality of its air, water, or even soil. The city that showcases Latin's Delhi to the whole world also simultaneously has more than 1,700 unauthorized colonies and slum clusters, where the level of social and public infrastructure is of a completely different, dismal dimension. The city that boasts of second highest per capita income in the country also has places like Yamuna Pushta, where the quality of life probably is no better than that of sub-Saharan Africa. The city that boasts of global standards of medical and health infrastructure, which is resulting in medical tourism, also simultaneously has annual outbreaks of vector-borne and waterborne diseases. And it has also simultaneously become one of the epicenters of cities with lifestyle diseases. Obesity has become a major area of concern. Liver diseases, heart diseases. So this is the background with which we start. The urbanization which is taking place in Delhi, the in-migration is a given thing. In 2011 census, we were 16.8 million, and we have already crossed 20 million now. And this onslaught of in-migration, which is there, and which is resulting in haphazard growth of urban character, is putting immense pressure on the civic services in Delhi. So as a starting point, we have to understand where do we stand in Delhi. For example, on the water supply front, our annual requirement of water which gets calculated from the requirement of 900 MGT of water, because Delhi is situated in semi-arid zone, 90% of it is catered to by the Ganga basin and Yamuna sub-basin, the surface water, and only 10% of it comes from the internal aquifers of Delhi and the groundwater. Only 84% of Delhi is supplied water through piped water supply. The rest of the population is catered to by either public hydrants or tankers. In terms of sewerage system, only 2/3 of the geographical area of Delhi is connected to sewerage system. And rest 1/3, the sewage goes untreated into the drains and the water bodies, thereby going to Yamuna and making it polluted to unacceptable levels of BOD and dissolved oxygen. On the municipal solid waste front, with the generation of more than 11,000 metric tons of municipal solid waste daily, only 55% of it gets processed and treated, and rest 45% goes untreated to these landfill sites. And these landfill sites also are not scientifically engineered landfill sites. They are just dump sites. And these three mountains of trash at Bhalaswa, Okhla, and Ghazipur, which have come up with 33 million tons of legacy waste, that's a huge amount of trash to handle. On the power supply front, for example, in 2002, we unbundled the then Delhi Vidyut Board, where the generation was corporatized and the distribution was privatized. And the peak load has now increased to more than 7,000 megawatts. The public transportation, with more than 350 kilometers of Delhi Metro and about 5,000 DTC and cluster buses, we are still finding it difficult to cater to the requirements of the citizens. And as a result, the private ownership of vehicles is alarmingly high, more than 600 vehicles per 1,000 population, putting extreme pressure on the traffic circulation, parking. Rather, a new genre of crime, crimes over parking, people are almost ready to kill one another on parking. And the environmental pollution, which is coming out through the vehicular emissions, and which, when it is coupled with the pollution which is coming out from the industrial operations, both in the industrial areas and the non-conforming areas, and also the burning of waste, which takes place both in and around Delhi, the air in Delhi generally remains poisonous all over the year. So this is where we stand. And hence, what we need to do together is to ensure that the process of urbanization in Delhi, the growth of Delhi, takes place in a manner in which we can really call Delhi a smart city. And in that process, a harmonious relationship with all of you is very important. And I think it is in that context that this today's engagement becomes very important. As has been said, that Delhi is the cultural capital and has had a long tradition of events and performances. We need to build upon that. the potential of the event management industry, both in terms of provisioning of employment. I have been told already on the MSME side, more than 3 million people are directly or indirectly related. And simultaneously, the cultural branding of the city that it can do, that is a potential which Delhi has to exploit through a partnership with all of you. And Delhi offers a wide range of choices because there are iconic landmarks which are there in Delhi. Whether it is Yamuna or Mughal architecture or Delhi Six Food or Delhi Metro and so on and so forth. So we'll work together through a partnership with all of you. We would also want that Delhi does come out as a wedding destination. And there, it is imperative that we in the government and all of you, we work together to ensure that this experience of wedding becomes a pleasant experience for everybody. Today, wedding season is generally called a nightmarish season by the entire city, except probably the families who are getting wed. And I suppose their joy and happiness and mirth is also significantly attenuated by the hassles that they also have to go through. Let us work together on this. From this forum, with full conviction and command at my disposal, let me make this statement that we will work very, very closely with you and ensure that the difficulties and the hassles that are faced by the industry, either through multiple systems of procedures, different agencies which you have to go to, and the delay that takes place in getting approvals, or the last minute cancellations, we will work together to ensure that those issues are taken care of. We will have a joint group made of the departments of administration and all of you. We need you more than you need us. Let me summarize it by this. My best wishes to all of you. Thank you very much.